Hi, I'm Michael Buchwalder. Join me here at Feeder Master Michael Buchwalder for some winter feeder tips. At open water venues here at Feeder, I always like to try and fish two lines. I always start by feeding a long line at the start, maybe 5 or 6 feeder falls. And then I pick up this rod. This is an 11-foot rod with a smaller reel, smaller feed, everything scaled down. 011, 013 hook lengths, 16 to 20 hooks, and a small feeder. The reason I have this rod, most people won't set it up around me, is I like to feed my long line and then come on this line and let everyone else tell me when to go on it. By priming my long line and resting it, I'm hoping that a few bream might come in, because we're only fishing for 3, 4, 5 bream today. So if you go in and clatter them straight away, the chances are you might not get any more. So by letting the guys either side of me fill their long lines in and keep feeding it, if they catch a fish, I know straight away to pick the 12-foot rod up and go straight out long. But this one gives me a chance to put maybe a pound and a half, 2 pound of fish in it early. There's a couple of things. 11-foot rod is perfect for chucking about 30 to 35 metres, no more really, otherwise you start to lose your accuracy. Always try and look for about 8 foot of water, which I think is about a 2.5 to 3 count on an ounce and a half bomb. It's important to find that depth nowadays as winter time's coming and the fish seem to sit at certain levels. You're not going to come up the shelf and catch them like you would do in June or July. It's November at the moment. And interestingly, the guys around you on bream venues, you get 2 or 3 fish in a row normally. So I know exactly when to pick that rod up and go on it because they'll tell me. But this way I get a chance of getting a few bonus fish in the net before they do. Right, I'm going to talk to you about braid. I tend to use braid for about 90% of my feeder fishing now. And the only time I wouldn't use it is fishing for big barbel or big carp. I use braid for a number of reasons. The bite detection is brilliant, second to none. You get a bite, you know it's on, the tip right round. I tend to fish braid straight through nowadays as well, unless I'm fishing a big venue that's snaggy, something like the River Earn, full of big boulders, and you break off a lot of feeders. What I don't want to be doing is tackling up again. I want to tie a new shock leader on and I'm fishing again straight away. The only other time I wouldn't use it is fishing long, ultra long distance, 70 metres plus. Because braid's 012 diameter, so you're casting that's a lot of pressure of 80 grams through your index finger. If you have a slip or a mishap, you're cutting your finger off, so I tend to use a 10 pound plus shock leader on that. The diameter's 030 plus, less chance of mishap. I used to use 08 braid for all my feeder fishing, but I used to have problems with it coming off the spool too quickly and causing wind knots. I now use 012 braid for all my feeder fishing. Line lay's perfect, seems to take a bit more water on, which makes it come off the spool a bit slower. It's perfect for me. Just going to show you my setup today for Thursday. This is the first one. I'm going to show you from a short line. It's 11-foot rod with a 3000 reel. Braid straight through with a little bit of a difference. I've got a 60 centimetre 0.22 fluorocarbon shock leader. This is there. It enables me, if I get a tangle, to change it quickly. By fishing short sometimes, you end up getting tangles, trying to rush, trying to get things happening. So that gives me a chance. I carry these spare in my bag, change it over, job done. 60 centimetre hook length to a size 16 PR333. It doesn't get any simpler than that, nice and easy. I'll quickly show you my other rod now I've got set up for me longer line. It's a 12'6" rod, one of the new Superiors with a 5000 reel, bit of a bigger reel, bit of a longer chuck. This is braid straight through to a snap link swivel. And above that, I've got 2 stots, number 8s, holding in place a size 20 swivel. This is a 75 centimetre hook length. The reason I use it on a swivel is, reeling 50, 60, 70 metres, you get a lot of line twist if you're not going a bit careful. I want to alleviate that. I want to be the first one in, first one back out again. On a race, it's imperative you're in and out of that tangles. This enables me to do that. I use it with 95% of my feeder fishing everywhere I go. Rivers, lakes, wide canals. It covers every option you need to do. It's a perfect setup, it's tangle free, ideal. One of the biggest things this year for me has been when you're getting no bites, going into the last hour of a match, really struggling, can't work out where the next fish is coming from, is this stuff, pure red worm. What I like to do is, quick little pinch of it into your ground bait, it starts to dance straight away. Goes mad as soon as the salt or something in the ground bait fish meal. A couple of little quick snips like that. I'll show you now exactly what it looks like in the feeder. It goes mad. A couple of red worms on the hook. And the amount of times this year I've gone out and caught a fish on that with like 2 or 3 minutes to go. Been brilliant for me. Feeder Master this year on the final, I caught four skimmers, £2 a piece in the last hour, just doing that, feeding red worm like that, two red worms on the hook, a single maggot, been brilliant. Got me from being nowhere to being second on the first day. So my top tip, I didn't want to tell you, but I've been forced to. Quickly run through my ground baits I've used today at Thursden. I've used 50-50 method and paste, worm fish meal. The only thing I've done differently is I always flower sieve it this time of year just to remove some of the food content. Most ground baits nowadays are pellet based, so the food content's really, really high. Perfect for summertime, not so good for November, December, January, February time. Always put it through a flour sieve. It's quick and easy, takes 2 minutes, but all the leftover pellets are nice, save for the summertime. Places I go, Ferry Meadows, Staunton and Harold, you need to put loads of bait in. So by saving it, you're cutting down the cost. If you look how fine that is now, it's perfect. Fish meal is really important on venues like Thurston Lake. All around it's carp hanger. They put pellets in, they put loads of spod mix in, loads of fish meal boilies. So bream, even the roach and perch all become used to fish meal. So it's imperative that you fish it on places like this. You just won't compete on a sweet mix, unfortunately. So always sieve it, always save the bits. Great tip, saves the money in the long run for you.